TFNN. Headline news update.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Tommy O'Brien, coming to you live from TFNN headquarters in St. Petersburg, Florida. It's Monday, 9 a.m. Eastern Time, 30 minutes to go until the opening bell. And we start off again in positive territory on the heels of the Friday Phase 1 deal with China. A little bit light on the details, but the market nonetheless, all-time highs. S&Ps right now, we'll get it in the positive territory. You see the chart up there, 3192, a high of 3193. You have S&P futures up 17 points this morning. That's almost 6.6% to start it off. Dow futures up 82, or about 0.3%, trading at 28,247. NASDAQ futures up 0.6% as well, 52 points in the green. NASDAQ trading 85.73. Oil, $60.21. And the 10-year yield, 1.857%. Start things off. Let's jump over the charts. We'll start it off with a couple of the indices. There's your chart of the Dow, 28,245. And you can see the slow rise from about 1 a.m. Eastern time. We're up about 90 Dow points from that level. NASDAQ 100, 85.73. Again, record territory, jumping to higher levels. S&P 500, there's your S&P, trading to right now 3192.62, just making all-time highs within the last few minutes. There's your crude oil chart. Crude trading at $60.18. Back things up even to last night. We were trading down there at about 59.74. So you're talking about a good 40 pennies to the upside. And to pull up the gold contract this morning, gold trading at 14.82 right now. You get the gold contract just off the highs that it made a few minutes ago of 14.83. In terms of what else you have happening in the market, jumping back to the news of the day. And that news being U.S.-China trade deal reached in Friday, but some key details are unclear. U.S. and China on Friday announced a process on a trade agreement. So you still have $250 billion of goods being taxed at 25%. The additional $100-plus billion, I believe it's $150 billion, that tax reduced from 15% to 7.5%. And to jump around to some of the markets and the stocks making news today, what else you have? Boeing. Considering halting the production of the 737 MAX, as that delay going back to further than they were admitting, that is going to carry into at least, it looks like, January 2020 for that delay. And Boeing this morning looking open about 328, closed Friday at 341. Stay tuned, folks. We got Basil Chapman filling in live for Larry Pesavento at 9 a.m. I'll be back at 10 o'clock with Tom, live programming all day. We'll be right back.